Hi YouTube, this is Michigan Snow Pony or Renee, and I have a new toy. I am entering the world of solar cooking, and so far, so good. I've had this oven for quite a while and just haven't gotten around to actually experimenting with it and trying it out. And I got around to it the other day and made a real simple beer bread in it. Turned out great. It was very easy to use. I'm geeked out of my mind about it. And today I'm trying a dinner. I'm using one of my favorite crock pot recipes called butter beef. And I put some potatoes and some dried mushrooms, soup mix. Anyway, and I'm going to let it sit there all day like a crock pot. I'm trying to keep the temp down. This thing is phenomenal as far as the temp it reaches. Yesterday I had it up to a little bit over 350, no problem. Our weather here is sunny, of course. We've got pretty much blue sky. Yesterday we had a few clouds. Excuse me. And it was about, in the 70s yesterday, high 70s. Today's supposed to be 83. There's just a very slight breeze. And I'm just going to see what the temperature is. It is, let me see, get my watch here. It's quarter after 10 in the morning. I've had this out about half an hour, and I want to try to keep it like a slow cooker. Oh good, we are just over 200 degrees. I've got it partially shaded. You probably can't see that at all because of the glare. But it's about 220 right now. And that's kind of where I want to keep it all day. Like a crock pot. So I've got it tilted a little bit away from the sun. And my husband's going to come out here later because I have to go to bed. I worked last night. And he's going to turn it a little bit more westerly direction just to try to keep the temp down. Because if it faces the sun head on, that's when it gets up to 350, and I want to slow cook this today. This is a commercially made Sunoven. That's the name, Sunoven. It's made in the United States in Elburn, Illinois. And if you want to check it out, you go to www.sunoven.com. And I wish I was clever enough to make one myself. There's all kinds of YouTube videos about it. In fact, Centerville TN, his channel, he has made one that's working quite well for him, I believe. So you can find the plans, but I just didn't feel qualified. I'm not a very good carpenter. So I went online, researched them. This particular brand seemed to have the best reviews. It wasn't cheap, but then I'm just spending paper fiat money for it, right? And now I have something tangible worth something. And anything that gets me a little bit off the grid, I'm tickled pink over. This is very well made. I'm pretty pleased with the construction. I'm going to zoom out here a minute. There, a little bit better. This is wood and a plastic housing. Inside, it's metal. In the back here has an extendable bar that you can adjust. You push this little... there it is. Push this little knob in. I'd need another hand to show you. And then just adjust it up or down as far as getting the right tilt. It has a very nice heavy glass cover. I could touch it, but it's hot. And two little latches right here that secure it very snug. These fold down. And there's the strap. And it has a strap that snaps these panels to the base. Put that in behind. And then you can carry it around with this little handle right here. And it's very light. Even though it's pretty substantial, as far as construction wise, it's not heavy to carry around. Inside, you can't, maybe you can see this, it has a swinging plate so that when you do tilt it, your food stays level. And it came with two pots like this, although you can only fit one in at a time. But that's okay. I didn't have any pots like this. You have to cook in dark pots with the solar oven. Or you should. Some people paint mason jars black on the outside and then leave a real thin strip with tape so you can see what the inside of your container's doing. And they use those for their cooking pots. That would work really well. I haven't really found anything I don't like about it. But I've only used it, this will be the second time. and I'm cooking a main dish. Yesterday was bread that came out. I'll show you a picture of that. Just like it always turns out. See, that came out really well, just like it does in my normal oven. And that, I cooked it actually for 2 hours, almost 2 hours. I probably could have shortened it to an hour, would have been fine. The literature says it's really hard to burn things in these, and that thrills me because I can shrink polyester and burn just about anything. So, I'm certainly going to test that out, that claim. But like I say, I left the bread in about twice as long as what I discovered it recommends, and it was fine. So, it wasn't even too brown. So, and actually, I have two of these. This one I got from the company, and the other one I got from eBay. It's supposedly brand new, never been used, but they sold it for about $100 less than what this one cost. This one was about $269. Yeah, I know, ouch. But so far it's working, and I wanted some way of cooking in the summer without heating up my oven because I have a very small house. We have one great room, kitchen, living room, dining room, it's all one big room. So when I heat that oven up, my whole house is hot in the summer. And we don't have central air. We have two air conditioning units in the bedrooms. So this is going to be great. I am going to test it out when there's snow on the ground because supposedly there goes a big truck. Supposedly you can use it even in cold temperatures as long as there's sun. I'm going to test that out. We'll see. And also they say on partly cloudy days it just takes everything longer to cook, but it still works. So we'll definitely see then. I'm just going to be experimenting around with it. And I wanted two because I thought I could bake bread in one and make a main dish in this one, or make a dessert in one and a main dish, or whatever. This is the south side of our house. This is my embarrassment section. It's just weed bed. I'd like to put cold frames here someday. I don't know if I'll get around to it. But I've got this little antique wash tubs. And this makes a really good place to set the oven. It works out really well here. And anyway, I'll let you know how the main dish turns out. Okay, it's done. There's our beef and potatoes and mushrooms, and now the official taste test. Go ahead.
Good!
Oh, he's going back for a second opinion.
I'm getting one of those mushrooms.
Yeah, I should have reconstituted those before I put them in there just with water. Are they okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh, are you going to eat supper with the girls? Are you going to eat it here?
Oh, it's all good.
There's a potato.
And hot.
Yeah, well, that thing was steaming when I opened it up. Oh, water, water.
Water.
Okay. There it is, butter beef, done in the solar oven with the blackened mushrooms. I probably should have reconstituted those, but I guess they're all right. It just turned really dark. Ha ha, Consumers Energy, didn't get to charge me for cooking this.